You know, 2 years ago, Rista and I were riding on the gator down the edge of some ag fields, and this deer with these extremely giant brow tines jumped up right in front of us and went down the ditch, and Rista was pumping me to hunt him, and either one of us, it was a great deer to try to hunt, but we immediately went in, put in a water tank, put out some cameras, and started getting him pictures of him right away. Right about the last few days in August, disappeared, not another picture of him till late October. Got one in late October and one in November. So he, you know, definitely the deer probably had a summer range and a fall range and was just breezing back through there, maybe chasing does. Well, you know, I really wanted to get on that deer early because I knew he had left us the year before, but we really had some really great Milo, and I was glassing in the afternoons and was still getting him on camera, and I felt pretty confident about it. We slipped in one afternoon, and the first afternoon we hunted him, we spotted him at like 500 yards away out in the Milo.
Can I see way out there to the left of that gap in those trees?
But then again, as I got to watching him out in the Milo, I was a little bit worried because we had an extra wet year. The Milo grew extra tall, and we couldn't see anything but his horns. And there was completely no shot available, even if we'd have got out of the blind and put a stalk on him. Well, you know, we spotted this deer at 575, but after a couple of days of hunting him, we weren't seeing him much anymore in the Milo, and we were seeing other bucks stand up out there. And so I was beginning to wonder, was he staying there all the time? Because a lot of the pictures were, if we'd get him at all after several days, was 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. So I had a hunch for a place across the road that this deer frequented in the past, sort of back where we got pictures of him earlier. So I went out and set a camera out there, and you know, we went in, checked the camera. Lo and behold, there he was yesterday morning. That morning at 6:37, and I told Paul Johns, it was the cameraman was with me. I said, he's over here on this side. With a picture at 6:37, which was at the crack of light, I knew good and well he wouldn't go back across those open pastures to that Milo field. So he was on that side of the road. And there's a grass ditch and some CRP out there that, from past history hunting these deer, that's where they're going to bed. And I told Paul Johns, I said, if he's over here, he's in that grass ditch right there. And we set up our stand right quick, and wind was blowing like 20 miles an hour that afternoon, so it was really galing. Hunting with these black powder guns, I was going back over my charts that Alan Rovig from McWhorter Custom Rifles had built the gun, had sent me about the wind drift in a 20 mile an hour wind. And at 200 yards, you were talking about like 10 inches, but with a 20 mile an hour gale. So I was having to think about allowing for that and hoping the wind would subside some before we got a crack at him.
Paul, big buck. Big buck right here.
At 7:20, I turned around and saw him jump the fence out into the field, and I sort of lost my composure a little bit, but I guess in a good way. But I finally got the gun out the window and got braced up, and he went walking out down the parallel to the fence, headed to a water tank that's about 300 yards to the south of us.
I see him now. You want him?
He's behind grass.
He's gonna walk behind a tree on me.
Find him. He's still right there. Just put his head up.
You know, the crack of the gun, I didn't know what had happened. And, you know, I was almost panicking there because he was in that tall grass, and I lost him a couple of times. I was trying to get back up from Riston and Paul to tell me where he was at, and I finally found him in the scope, and at the crack of the gun, I didn't see him anymore at all, so they immediately told me that he had dropped. Boy, I was relieved, but, you know, the Chinese fire drill was going on because I was pouring powder and ramming rods and bullets and trying to get a reload in. Riston and I bailed out of the blind, and after I got the gun reloaded, and I couldn't get out there fast enough because, you know, when you got one dropped, you sure want to go get your hands on him. He fell in some high grass, so couldn't see him. And when we got out there, the celebration came in. It was so great to have Riston with me because he was with me the first time I ever laid eyes on the deer. And he's been there with me through the whole thing for 2 years, working and putting water out and scouting and everything. So nothing better to be able to have your son have that come full circle with you to be able to take a deer like that. Well, buddy, this is 2 years we've been after this rascal. He shedded his velvet last year and we never saw him again.
Yeah, I remember that.
I mean, we had the big brush. You remember we saw him 2 years ago in the summertime. And we've been hunting him across the road, spotted him the other day across the road out in the Milo. And he was at 565 yards and thought about going after him, but the Milo was just too high. Came over here across the road, and I had a camera over here because I knew he used his side some as well. And we got his picture this morning at 6:30 this morning. And I knew good as well the old bed in this grass right here. And sure enough, about 7:30, I looked and saw him as he had come across the fence. But we got him, buddy. Mm-hmm. Come give me a hug again. Oh man, you did so good.
Thanks.
Wow. What you think about him there, buddy?
Yeah, he's still got that velvet on the back.
Isn't he something?
Mm-hmm, a little bit of velvet right there too.
Wow. You know, and to top it off, it was Riston's birthday. We had went over to one of my buddies, Ryan Cedars' home where he was hunting, and had birthday cake and had a party for Riston, and that was literally 3 hours before we shot the deer. So it was a special, special day to have him with me on his birthday and to be able to take an animal of that magnitude.